Benzene. It is a common laboratory solvent and reagent. Nowadays, it doesn't find its way out of the laboratory very often. The fact that it is toxic and carcinogenic has made it unlikely to find its way into common use. But once upon a time, it was used as everything from a hand wash to an aftershave. There was a time when benzene was utterly ubiquitous, a time when it wasn't understood, and a time when benzene was the center of a scientific controversy. The controversy centered around benzene's structure. Spectroscopy of the day could determine that benzene was a molecule of 6 carbons and 6 hydrogens. There were several structures proposed, some sensible enough, some more bizarre, but none adequately explained the unique properties of benzene. Benzene was shown to be significantly more stable than estimated values for a cyclic conjugated triene. Clearly, this was no ordinary molecule. The controversy was put to rest when a radically different structure was proposed. Friedrich August Kekulé, an organic chemist of German origin, published a paper detailing his revelation in 1865. The story goes that he had an epiphany after a vivid dream about a snake biting its own tail. An Ouroboros. What was revolutionary about Kekulé's structure was that it wasn't static. Unlike his contemporaries, Kekulé proposed that the electrons not only were not contained to any one bond, but were revolving around the entire ring. Benzene wasn't static. It wasn't just delocalized. It was aromatic. To further validate Kekulé's structure, it was shown that the charges moving around an aromatic ring generates a magnetic field, just like electricity moving along a wire. Who knew the toluene in gasoline made it slightly magnetic? So what sets an aromatic apart from the rest? Arenes are, without exception, cyclic. The very nature of electrons traveling in a closed loop requires a cyclic atomic framework on which they can move. By that same nature, arenes require a system of continuously overlapping p orbitals. Every atom in the system must contribute a p orbital to the cause. This is most often seen as alternating double and single bonds, such as benzene. There are a surprising number of ways compounds have achieved aromaticity without conforming to this pattern. Atoms can contribute lone pairs. In the case of pyrrole, the nitrogen has no double bond, but its lone pair extends into the system and completes it. P orbitals in a pi system must be in plane with each other, so arenes are necessarily planar. Pyridine is also aromatic, but unlike pyrrole, the lone pair of the nitrogen is not in plane with the rest of the pi system, and is therefore irrelevant to the system. Aromaticity is not a one-size-fits-all property. In an effort to predict aromaticity in a diverse amount of cyclic structures, Hückel's rule was proposed by Erich Hückel in 1931. The rule states that of the cyclic, unbroken p-orbital systems, only some may be called aromatic. Compounds that have exactly 4n plus 2, where n is any whole number, electrons in its broken system are predicted to be aromatic, and those whose numbers deviate are not aromatic. Benzene, with its 3 double bonds, put 6 electrons into its pi system, making it aromatic. Cyclobutadiene can only muster 4 electrons into a pi system, and it is not aromatic, despite its form factor. In fact, cyclobutadiene is uncharacteristically unstable for such a molecule, almost like the yin to benzene's yang. There is an addition to Hückel's rule, which explains the disparity. Compounds that fit all the criteria for aromaticity, but have 4n instead of 4n plus 2 electrons, are anti-aromatic, and are highly unstable due to their molecular orbital configuration. All other molecules are simply non-aromatic. They have no stakes in aromaticity, and have no out-of-place characteristics. Those molecules that fit Hückel's rule may be called aromatic, and have novel characteristics that come with this appellation, namely stability, both chemically and physically. The physical rigidity of arenes have given rise to amazing constructs, both man-made and natural. Although benzene has left the shelves of stores, this is not the end of the arene legacy. Next time, what's in the name of a rose so sweet?